1,000 hours away. So what will the future hold? Well, if you said humanoids with computer brains sheathed in synthetic flesh capable of conducting interviews on network television, oh, that's so 2011. Here's ABC's Jim Sciutto.
Hi, nice to see you.
An interview with Philip starts kind of like a bad date.
So how are things?
Things are good. There's some small talk.
I read books, newspapers, and news magazines.
Awkward pauses.
Can you please state the question in different words?
If you're lucky, something comes up that gets the chemistry flowing.
Do you like being a robot?
Being a robot at this time in history is really exciting because my technology is changing.
Philip is a state-of-the-art talking robot with a big vocabulary, complex facial expressions, a sense of humor, and something of an ego. He is, well, surprisingly human.
What's your favorite movie?
My favorite movie is Blade Runner. Have you seen Blade Runner?
I have.
Today, robots manufacture, clean, perform operations, win Jeopardy.
Who is Michael Phelps?
Yes.
But robots living and communicating like real human beings, or something close to it, is very new.
Are these the makings of the next robot brain?
Yeah, so the Robokind has an onboard Atom processor that can see faces and understand speech and then wirelessly connect to an intelligent server. So
among the most successful innovators is David Hanson, who believes we're a lot closer to living robots than we realize.
Robots will someday, or may, wake up. They may be really smart. They may be as creative, smart, and capable as human beings.
For Hanson, that means both words and all the expressions and movements that go into the way we communicate with each other. So he developed a human-like robot flesh called Frubber, designed to allow a robot face to show all the emotions a human face does.
David made my body. He is an excellent artist and amazing inventor.
Is he God?
I think he is God. Better ask him to be sure, though.
Philip is not perfect. Far from it. We had lots of confusing exchanges.
Do you have a girlfriend?
Girls are one of the most valuable natural resources this planet has to offer.
There are some in the robot community who think that robots like Philip are at best a gimmick, at worst dangerous. They say robots will never truly be humans, and so they shouldn't look like them at all.
To raise machines with human-like values, we need to make them human-like.
In other words, if we want them to be our friends, and Hanson really does, they need to be more like us than like machines. We've all seen Terminator, after all.
I'll be back.
I will admit that in my first robot date, as strange and awkward as it was, I did like it.
It's gotta be a tough job to be a human being, and I'm glad I'm not one.
For Nightline, I'm Jim Sciutto in Dallas, Texas.
Well, something.